I never thought I'd say this, Sean, but I'm going to have to raise my voice above the roar of the dinosaurs.
Go, Sean!
Absolutely no better place to be. This is just like we've just gone back in time, more than 66 million years to a time when giant dinosaurs still roamed the earth.
Well, what is our fixation with dinosaurs?
Yeah, guys,
I think every generation had a dinosaur movie. For a lot of people, it's Jurassic Park. The newer generation has Jurassic World. Some of us had the Land Before Time. But the fact is, there's nothing on Earth quite like this today. And I think that's something the world really misses out. This gives us a chance to experience it for ourselves.
Talk to us about what we can see here at the exhibition.
Well, aside from we've just over a dozen of these fantastic animatronic dinosaurs, which they roar, they jump, some of them move around. And as well as that, we have some legitimate dinosaur bones, some that are nearly 70 million years old, the leg bone from the duck-billed dinosaur. One of the most famous fossils we have a replica of is one of a Velociraptor. I'm sure you've heard of them from Jurassic Park films. It was basically locked in mortal combat with another dinosaur, Protoceratops, a relative of this fellow. But what happened was they were both fighting, and the scientists think that a sandstorm took the two of them out at the same time and just entombed them in this wonderful fossil, which is priceless now. That's why we only have a replica. But the fact is, it kind of proved that even though Velociraptor was a bit smaller than how it is in the movies, we know that it was brave. It wasn't afraid to fight bigger dinosaurs than itself. It didn't always work, but it tried.
Well, I'm not feeling particularly brave at the moment because these are fierce-looking creatures. Let's start with Triceratops. What were their traits?
Well, the name Triceratops speaks for itself. It means tree-horned face. And despite this fearsome appearance, you know, big horns, a sharp beak, big frills with spikes on it. If you look closely, it has flat teeth. So that is the mouth of an anteater. So a lot of people think the dinosaurs were out biting each other, but most of them were peaceful plant eaters, being quite happy to be left alone. Of course, the reason for these great defenses is that Triceratops had a noisy neighbor, and you probably know what it's called.
T-Rex?
That's the one.
We all love T-Rex.
Hey, say hello to his neighbor. So we call it the Tyrant Reptile King, because Rex means king, because we thought it was the king of the dinosaurs. Now,
tiny alarms,
but this was a really clever strategy by T-Rex, because if you took away big arms, which it wasn't really using, you could put more weight on its head, keep that crushing bite, which makes it famous. There were some bigger meat-eating dinosaurs, but we can calculate from the muscle attachments on their jaws that T-Rex is by far the strongest. If it was alive today, it would have no problem munching through metal. So when you see it biting through that car in Jurassic Park, there's no question that it could have done that.
Sean, this little
fella's
pretty special, but why is that?
Well, this is a Neobenator. He's a local fellow. I live in the UK, so that's about as close as we have at the moment to an Irish dinosaur. Happy strange skin on its face, which they think gave it an extra sense that we don't have. Hence why it probably was a very, very successful hunter.
We often hear the term Jurassic period bandit. What exactly does that mean?
Well, the periods of the reign of the dinosaurs. The Triassic, when the first dinosaurs appeared and started to take over the world gradually. Jurassic was when they kind of conquered and started growing to enormous sizes. And the Cretaceous was when they really had taken over, and the really famous dinosaurs, Tyrannosaurus, Triceratops, they ruled the world. Until about 60-odd million years ago, a meteorite brought the rain to it. So what abrupt end.
So is that guy from the last period?
Yes, this is a hadrosaur, the most common successful dinosaur. There was more hadrosaurs than any other kind of dinosaur back in the day. It doesn't have big teeth or spikes. It was really, really good at eating. Some of them had up to 1,000 teeth, so they could munch through plants and digest them and get the nutrients as fast as possible, grow big real fast.
Good at eating. I would have done well back then.
So there were three main types of dinosaurs. You have the carnivores who ate meat, the herbivores who ate plants, and the omnivores who ate pretty much whatever they liked. So they're probably the best dinosaurs to eat. A lot of people might be surprised, but this is what the Velociraptor actually looked like. Most people know from Jurassic Park, it's bigger, scalier, but in real life, it's a lot more like a bird than it would be a lizard.
So the Velociraptor essentially is a fancy blow dry.
A bouncy blow dry, or a murder bird, as I like to call it.
Sean, look how maternal this lady dinosaur looks.
Who's this now? This is Oviraptor. Now, this is probably the greatest framing of all time in history. But see, the name Oviraptor means egg thief, because when they found it, it was over this nest, and they thought it was actually plundering the nest to rob the eggs. When they examined the eggs a little closer, they realized it wasn't a thief. It was, in fact, a really good mother and was actually caring for its nest. But it did prove to us that not only were dinosaurs parents, they're very good parents.
Well, you can see why this exhibition is proving so popular with young and old alike. What a wonderful way to spend an afternoon.
Oh, absolutely. And 80,000 visitors can't be wrong. But we call it dinosaurs around the world, and that's fair, because these are dinosaurs from all over the world, many different time periods. But what a lot of people don't know is we've only found between 5 and 10% of all the dinosaur species that have ever existed. So if there's anyone out there who wants to grow up to be a dinosaur expert, there's plenty more out there to be discovered. So you never know. Get digging. You could have a dinosaur named after you someday.
I think perhaps it's a little bit too late for a career change for me, but budding dinosaur enthusiasts can check out this exhibition. Dinosaurs Around the World takes place until the end of August.
Hey!